get more than a million doses of cholera vaccine as cases of the disease surge on the heels of Hurricane Matthew. And it's brought a good start for the West Indies A team on day one, the second unofficial test against Sri Lanka. Brad Robertson, this is Caribbean Intent for Tuesday, October 11th. I'll be back with the details.
Challenge winner Dornell Simon and more. October 30th from 5 p.m. at SJBC Back Car Park Now, Restoration City. General ticket 75 EC. Groups of 10 or more pay 60 EC. Fully catered VIP. Food and drinks all night for only 250 EC with stage-side peeling. VIP parking. Children under 12, 25 EC at the door. Children under 5 free at our kids zone with bouncy castle games and supervision. Get tickets at SJBC office. Will City, Raj Collection, all Digicel outlets. Townhouse Megastore, HBK Villas, Jolly Harbor. Get VIP tickets only at SJBC office or call 268-562-7493. This is the biggest worship festival in the Caribbean, and the only thing missing is you. Get your tickets today.
Antigua and Barbuda, where the beach is just the beginning.
The World Health Organization today announced it will send a million cholera vaccine doses to Haiti, which has been seen, which had seen cases of the disease surge since Hurricane Matthew ravaged the country last week. The hurricane came as Haiti was still struggling to cope with the disease. Cases were already rising, with 29,000 reported since the beginning of the year. That's an average of nearly 800 a week. WHO cholera expert Dominique Legros says the hurricane hit Haiti just as the country was approaching the time of the year when it generally records most cholera cases. There had been a sharp increase in cases in the south. That's the part of the country that was hardest hit by Hurricane Matthew. Legros says in an attempt to try to halt the spread of the deadly disease, WHO has decided to send 1 million vaccine doses to Haiti for a large-scale immunization campaign. And a week after the passage of Hurricane Matthew, relief supplies are only now beginning to trickle into Les Cayes, one of the departments severely affected by the Category 4 cyclone. Matthew not only left more than 1,000 people dead, but left hundreds of thousands homeless in the south and southwestern parts of Haiti, particularly in the communities of Les Cayes and Jeremy. Yesterday, two containers carrying pasta, rice, oil, and other supplies for distribution were delivered at the Emergency Operations Center, that's the EOC, in Les Cayes. They arrived as the CARICOM operational support team, COST, was in the process of activating the operations center. In a brief meeting with CDEMA's operations specialist, General Earl Arthurs, who heads COST, regional governor for Les Cayes, Luis Paul Rafael, expressed disgust and frustration that supplies had not been reaching the most affected people. He said many had no more food or homes or anywhere to go and was tired of the talk and wanted to see something done for those people. General Arthurs assured Rafael that though his mission is to provide support to the EOC, he would do what he could to convey the concerns to the relevant authorities so the problem could be addressed. Another news now, the chairman of Guyana's Public Service Commission is challenging a tribunal set up to determine his future. Carvel Duncan walked out on the first day of the tribunal's sitting yesterday and signaled his intention to boycott the rest of the hearings. His lawyer Arnold Landelau says the plan is to challenge the legitimacy of the tribunal which TV's Andrew Duncan divorced.
Arthur Duncan and his attorney Arnold Landelau on Monday afternoon were held in the tribunal appointed by President Granger to inquire, investigate, and recommend whether Duncan, who has been serving as chairman of the Public Service Commission and member of the Police Service Commission and the Judicial Service Commission, should be removed from the Police Constitutional Office. The administration is forced to pursue on grounds that Mr. Duncan has failed to effectively carry out his duties, coupled with the fact that he's currently before the court on a fraud charge. Before the White House, Duncan's defense attorney made an objection that the tribunal should not proceed to hear and determine the matter.
The grounds are one, that there are criminal proceedings pending in the United States, and those proceedings have not been completed. That Mr. Duncan, under Article 144 of the Constitution, is entitled to the presumption of innocence.
The court has stated that based on that presumption, Duncan is innocent until proven guilty.
This tribunal is premature and is an infraction and a violation of that constitutional protection.
Give us your third case for it, isn't it?
Third case in the prison of visit.
I don't know if that's a fair question. I've been to a lot of places over there. I've been to St. Thomas, St. John's. Obviously, I've been to Barbados, been to Bahamas. So I don't really think you could have a fun place that you would go. Oh, sorry, I was asking that. No, you know what? I think the islands are really cool.
The West Indies A team picked up a commanding lead on day one of the second unofficial test against Sri Lanka A in Palakkad today, sent in to bat with 18-43 and 21-3 on 89 overs. It was built by a strong partnership between Antiguan wicketkeeper batsman Jamal Hamilton and Guyanese batsman Vishal Singh. Hamilton fell one run short of his fourth first class century, while Singh produced a well-played 81 from 165 balls. Opening batsman Rajendra Chatwicker was retired through from 50, while Shimon Hetmeyer was bowled on 48. Larry Kumara, Anil Fernando, Charles Aslanta, and Dimuth Karunaratne picked up one wicket each. And in football now, Guyana's head coach Jamal Shabazz is hoping his team will use its home advantage to beat Jamaica in the third round qualifying competition this evening in Guyana. The Golden Jaguars are facing elimination from the CFP Caribbean Cup after being handed a 3-0 drubbing by Suriname over the weekend. According to Shabazz, the team must find courage to play against the defending champions. Meanwhile, Captain Christopher Norris made an appeal for the Guyanese public to rally around the national football team in tonight's crucial encounter. That's Caribbean Inter. Join us again at 6:30 for Caribbean Newsline. Good afternoon.